How does Elon Musk manage to get his SpaceX employees to build rockets so quickly and still have time to post memes on Twitter? Since June 2010, rockets from the Falcon 9 group have launched 114 times, with 112 successful launches. The SpaceX lineup dominates rocket flights because of their innovation and how efficient their rockets are. They're currently the only privately owned company that successfully delivers humans to the International Space Station. SpaceX handles about two-thirds of NASA's launches, including many research payloads, with flights as cheap as $62 million, roughly two-thirds the price of a rocket from United Launch Alliance, a competitor. So with all of these workloads, it begs the question, how does SpaceX manage to build their rockets so fast? Straightforward answer? Through exceptional engineering. Their rockets are all made with innovative technology. And since 2014, hypersonic grid fins made of titanium have been installed on all the SpaceX rockets, contributing to their rockets' smooth landing. Elon Musk says these fins will be manufactured from welded steel on future Starship vehicles. The costs of their materials are relatively cheaper. Musk says carbon fiber costs about $135 per kilogram, which about 35% of it is wasted in the manufacturing process. Thus, Musk has opted for the cost-saving option in stainless steel, which costs about $3 per kilogram. And Elon explains that this is even more beneficial because it allows the company to experiment freely without much fear of losing lots of money compared to using carbon fiber. In his words, he said, "Very easy to work with steel. Oh, and I forgot to mention, SpaceX's high-quality carbon fiber is $135 a kilogram, 35% scrap, so you're starting to approach almost $200 a kilogram. 301 steel is $3 a kilogram." So rather than using computer simulations which aren't always accurate, the company can opt for cheaper materials that will allow them to perform more real-life experiments and collect more accurate data. It's also worth noting that stainless steel is resilient and durable in colder temperatures. In an interview when backing up the stainless steel, he said, "The best design decision on this whole thing is 301 stainless steel, because at cryogenic temperatures, 301 stainless has about the same effective strength as an advanced composite or aluminum lithium," Musk said. Unlike most steels, which get brittle at low temperature, 301 stainless gets much stronger. Its strength-to-weight ratio at cryogenic temperatures is equivalent, or even perhaps slightly better than, advanced composites or aluminum lithium, he said. This is not well appreciated because if you just look at the materials manual and say what the strength of stainless steel is, it looks much weaker than it is. If you say what the strength at cryogenic temperature is, much, much stronger at very low temperature, almost twice as strong. That's when it becomes better than carbon fiber or aluminum lithium. Another way they're able to save time is with their heat shield. The average space rocket has about 21,000 heat shield tiles, which have to be inspected one after the other before they're fit to travel. But SpaceX's rockets don't have to go through the same problems. SpaceX's Starship can survive in extreme situations, so that's not a worry. This in turn gives them more time. Musk also talked about how a transpiration cooling system may be enough for their Starships instead of installing thousands of heat shield towers. It's a system whereby the ship would have two exterior stainless steel layers and cooling liquids or water would flow through the sandwich layers. They're also developing technology to control the altitude of rockets. This will help the landing of the rockets easily. Plus, they're reusable and efficient economically. And this gets us closer to another answer, reusability. This helps them save costs and build rockets faster. Because their goal is to land and access space daily like airplanes, this is the more sensible approach for them. Musk said, "If one can figure out how to effectively reuse rockets just like airplanes, the cost of access to space will be reduced by as much as a factor of 100. A fully reusable vehicle has never been done before. That really is the fundamental breakthrough needed to revolutionize access to space." Also, their ability to source funds is credited for how they can build rockets quickly. For one, SpaceX is headed by the man who sits at either the second or top position in the world's richest man ranking. He's gained so much confidence from investors thanks to his many successes. Recently, SpaceX raised $850 million with a valuation of $74 billion. So, raising money is not an issue for the space travel company. Their construction process is the next thing on the list. Many companies have dedicated machinery that helps to do the bulk of the production work. This gives engineers double work, in which they no longer have to only maintain the rocket. They also have to maintain the machine that makes the rocket as well. Even the companies would have to pay double for funding the machine and funding the rocket. SpaceX's Starship is different. In their case, they don't use fancy machines that help to build parts. Their production process is as basic as men hand-welding the pieces together. SpaceX's components consist of stainless steel, flaps, and nose cones. Construction happens rather openly, so there's no machine doing the bulk of the work. Eyebrows have been raised concerning these construction processes' safety because their durability details are not precise. Still, Elon Musk and his factory in Boca Chica focus on efficiency and cutting down construction time. According to Space News, in an interview with Elon Musk, he said, "We're making good progress. The thing that we're making progress on with Starship is the production system," he said, referring to the growing campus at Boca Chica. "A year ago, there was almost nothing there, and now we've got quite a lot of production capability." Next is iteration. Because they're focused on speed, they're different from other companies, airline companies for example, who test after each process. And they fix any issues after they've tested everything individually. This usually takes years before an actual aircraft is ready to sell. But SpaceX's rockets are different. They usually don't expect to get their spacecraft to be perfect at the first trial. Their iterative process is more of learning and improving on the go. They release a working but yet imperfect version of the product. And they release more frequently, so they can spot errors and make improvements faster. This same iterative process has contributed to the Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy developments. SpaceX engineer David Geiger spoke about this iteration process and said, "We weren't just going to sit there and analyze something for years and years and years and years to the nth degree. SpaceX was built on test, 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 test. We test as we fly." But Elon Musk has spoken about how this process won't be sustainable in the long term. Because once people start using their rockets to travel to Mars more frequently, it'll be too risky to use this strategy. After all, you wouldn't want to be on a trip to Mars one day and have the parts of the rockets you're on fall out, would you? So, while they're still in this process, they aim to take full advantage of it. Another factor that contributes to SpaceX building rockets so quickly is Elon Musk's lifespan. In 2016, when Musk announced that humans could build a sustainable colony on Mars, he believed that this would be possible in the 2060s. He also said that in the next decade, his company would shuttle humans to and from Mars. In September 2018, he tweeted that a base on Mars could probably be built by 2028. Then, in March 2019, he tweeted again that it's possible to make a self-sustaining city on Mars by 2050 if we start in 5 years and take 10 orbital synchronizations. Elon Musk turns 50 in June, and he's not getting any younger. And because of how unpredictable life can be, he's doing all he can to speed up the process before he runs out of time. In an interview when talking about the topic, he said, "The thing that concerns me most right now is that unless we improve our rate of innovation dramatically, then there's no chance of a base on the moon or a city on Mars," Musk said. "This is my biggest concern." At SpaceX, he's famous for his deadlines and pushing his staff to get things done faster. The president at SpaceX, Gwynne Shotwell, in an interview with CNBC in May 2018, said, "There's no question that Elon is very aggressive on his timelines, but frankly, that drives us to do things better and faster." One other catalyst that keeps pushing SpaceX is the emerging competition. Although it may not currently seem like SpaceX has any competition, you can't just write off Jeff Bezos's Blue Origin so quickly. Bezos plans to step down as CEO of the biggest e-commerce company to focus on running his space travel company. So SpaceX could have a worthy opponent. To conclude, there are many reasons why SpaceX can build rockets so quickly, but on top of them is their efficiency in terms of picking and using materials, and of course, how they aim to learn on the go.